participated in, so it was a big function. And the chief minister of the state personally came, Mr. Kuhn, K-H-U-U-O-O-O-N. And he cut the ribbon in honor of these 12 rabbis. So there were thousands of devotees there for that grand opening. It's amazing. So we're building there in this land. The first phase is halls and seminar rooms and facilities for our guests and sannyasis to stay at office. And then I went to Vrindavan to the after the Sri Rath Yatras also, right?
No, you went to Vrindavan, then into Mayapur, I think, then came back to Malaysia.
Vrindavan had the Continental Festival.
Came back to Malaysia for the Radha Yatra Festival.
Then we went to the Bhishma Panchak in Mayapur. You know Bhishma Panchak? How many did Bhishma Panchak? A special 5 days in the end of Kartik, from Ekadasi to Purnima. You do that 5 days, one of three kinds of fasting. You worship Krishna, offer lamps to Krishna, bathe in the holy river, please do a Manas Puja. And very easily you can get back to God. In fact, it says that so much mercy comes that it cannot be calculated how much mercy comes from Bhishma Pasha. Over the scale, too. So we have 250 devotees eating fruits and roots for 5 days. First 2 days, okay, but after that, no. Go looking for the rice and ruchi. But, no, that's wrong. You have to go every day. You do Mayapur, it's especially good because Bhishma is the son of the Ganges, so we all do Bhishma Puja inside the Ganges. So. It's kind of interesting because we do tarpan. And the puja is tarpan. You know what tarpan is? Mm. What is tarpan? Tupper. Tarpan is offering a puja for in the holy river for the well-being of a forefather. So your grandmother passed away and you want to send her a package of some mercy. You can do tarpan and offer her. So there's a mantra for tarpan and for Bhishma Day. And it says, Achatma Brahmachari name. I think that's like one of the verses. Like, from his childhood, he's a Brahmachari. To the son of the sea, well. Although he didn't. So, see how Krishna arranges. He didn't have any children, but thousands and millions of his spiritual descendants are offering him Tarpana. Because all the Indian parents want, are hopeful that when I grow old, when I grow old, when I die, my ancestors, my descendants, rather, they'll do this puja for me. So in case I get stuck up in some lousy place, I get a special bonus. How many want to send the package for your previous forefathers? Mercy pack. So we did the speech for Panchayat, and then we had Mayapur. It's very special during Kartik months. Vrindavan was also super nice. It wasn't Vrindavan Kartik. But you know, the Vrindavan temple is smaller than the Mayapur temple.
Mm-hmm.
So Mayapur, they turn the lights and they have hundreds of candles and lamps and things in front of the deity. And then there's thousands of people that are in the pitting of the temple. Everybody's offering candles. But it's not candles, ghee wicks.
Mm-hmm.
They make thousands of ghee wicks every night. It's a different sponsor for it. So when you see everybody offering their lamps, it's a very, very special effect. You know, they're very nice singers. Ramishwaram Satchidanam Rupam. So then, you know.
So it might have been the ghee wicks here during the period.
Nice.
Yeah, the
ghee. You dim the lights and do it here?
The ghee wicks.
You dim the lights?
Yeah.
Turn off the lights on the ghee.
Oh, no.
On the ghee.
Not nightly, just.
They turn off and they have the candles for them. So when you're actually offering the lamp, you're illuminating the view of the world.
We were in Malaysian Radha Yatras, then from there we went to Krishna Kanaya Desh. Kauai.
That was 10, 12 days in Mayapur, and then we went to back to Malaysia after visiting a few places in India. You went to Silchar?
No, Kuwait.
I went to Kanaya Desh. We had three Rajatas, Kane,
Sumai Siput, Sumai Patani,
Sumai Patani,
Sumai Siput,
Sumai Siput. Three Rajatas, Kane, Stag. Then, very tight. End of the year, my programming was very tight. So this went over the bottom of this.
Yeah.
The bottom of this.
Silchar.
Back to India, went to Silchar, went to Orissa. He got very sick in Orissa. It's not very nice. But they had the, they said there were 10,000 people. This was the first time I went to this country. You were taping?
No.
Did you go to Carmen Gold's?
Yeah.
Undercover.
I changed when I went. But then, somehow, this is the first time in the history of they put in the whole group. Food system, and the government said it's definitely very good. But it never rains there, because it's a desert. It hardly rains, once in a blue moon. Hasn't rained for 20 years. So when we were there, we did a kirtan the whole night. Not the whole night, but we were moving the program in the house. There's about 50 devotees there. Congregation of blue and gold. So we had nice kirtans and everything. That night it torrential rains.
Yeah.
Cars flowing away. You know, it never rains because there's no drainage system. So I had a one flight to catch. We spent like 2 or 3 hours driving around trying to find a way out. Remember we got it was flooded. Finally, the very first place we were planning to go, but someone told them, oh, that way it's flooded. It turned out it wasn't flooded. It was an underpass that was flooded, but then you can go, you can scoop the underpass and just go, don't go under it. You go around it and go back. You can go back. But while we were doing all that, we got a flat tire, we were changing the tire. Ramana was busy. Then the water kept rising. And you could literally see cars floating, you know, floating down the road and up to the lights half covered with water. It was a really amazing thing. So Krishna showed he wants to flood this place. Somehow I got to the airport to do some of this other, but I missed all the flight. I was there for 4 hours in the airport. And talking to the devotees, a few of the devotees are with us. But it was exciting. I mean, we just got them all set up, they got a structure, and they got their own. No, we're doing to the expatriates. It's not advisable to do to the locals at this point because it's not a sectarian country. It's illegal to do anything. Even amongst the expatriates, it's illegal what to speak of. You're caught doing it to a local. In jail, it's too risky for. These locals. You should have a program here to preach to the Arabs that are going to school in America and Europe and get them to be devotees and let them go back and preach.
Yeah, good idea.
Because they can, you know, it's their country, they can do it. If a foreigner does it, they have no locals there.
Yeah, I know there's
something. They stick out to us. This one complaint. At least they can get someone complaining about it. They get away with it, so it's like that. Locals have all the power. So anyway, then for them, another place nearby called Balaram Desh.
My code name?
Code name. Everything is a code.
Turn up the table.
Yes, it
will. You'll ask me later. And there, in that place, actually, we've been legally registered by the Social Affairs Ministry. We give a registration that you're allowed to meet and have a society, and as long as nobody complains. So it's a very shaky. And just after getting registered, the local neighbors complained. But now they're going to shift to a new place and build us something. So maybe that's to actually legally be able to meet some very big thing. Most places you don't have a legal right to meet, you just sneak and meet. Here they can meet, but they have a very inconspicuous thing. Then where we go?
Silchar.
Silchar.
Then Bangkok, Australia, New Zealand.
No. So from Silchar we're going to go to...
Came back to Calcutta, went to Bangkok, bought the ticket, Bangkok, Australia, New Zealand, back to Australia. Then...
Okay, Silchar, then we went to Silchar. It's in the corner of India. Nobody, we keep all wanting to come there and see it sometime. Nobody knows, they're not there before, and they've only used to go there. Even Indian devotees are like, come with anyone. It's like way on the other side, like when you see the map of India, you have Bangladesh here. This is part of India that's on the opposite side of Bangladesh. Manipur, Tripura. So one section of it is called Kachar Assam. So they had a massive initiation. I've been there for over a year. You're all spoiled here. I've been here 6 months everywhere. I was there for almost 2 years. So somehow, it's very hard to get there. And once you're there, it's very hard to get out. They have one flight 5 days a week. And somehow you can never get a ticket out. I went there with a wait list ticket to come back, and we had to somehow use our influence and give us a ticket to come back. Mm. Otherwise, I'd have to drive 6 hours to go back to it. And there, there's lots of things.
Planes are better. You get to see the country, and they don't want you to come back. Trains are better, and if you go there, they don't want you to come back here. They want you.
No,
they want to capture you there.
It's really far. You might be going to complete around the brick.
You have a lot of work to do there.
By the train, yeah, a lot of work. That's the 3 days on the train. Anyway, it's a really nice program. So the boys are very happy. Let's spend some time with them. We went and transcended the Bangkok temple. It's my first visit to Bangkok for some years also. Now I'm going to visit a regular visit. They have a very nice program. Yeah, I found some of my disciples from Nepal were studying there. Aristocratic family and families. They started a Bhakti Diksha group and they have a Sunday program in the main park. They, later the Bhakti Vishwa, the main program was done by Bhakti Bhagavad Vash Govind Narasimha Maharaj and others. And we went to Australia, Melbourne. They have Snan Yatra and Boxing Day. You know Boxing Day? The day after Christmas. 26th December is called Boxing Day. It was that day the tsunami hit. But when I had already noticed, like, the first day it was like, it was a bit late.
Right.
Nobody knew that I was going to be there. It took a couple of days to sink in what actually was happening. Maybe President Bush didn't take it seriously at first. So that festival wasn't affected, but it was, we had that. We're next.
New Zealand.
For New Zealand for a day. Melbourne, I did every day morning walks, darshan, classes. They do a little, for the Snan Yatra, they have 1,000 people come and really bathe Jagannath. So it's a big festival. And their Jagannath are very weak. He has lotus feet. Never saw Jagannath lotus feet. So when they bathe him, you can see that actually he's got little lotus feet. Well, I could write to Andrew, and I'm sure it would be happy to share. And
is there one story that they asked Prabhupada about making the deity, Jagannath deity, with the big feet? And Prabhupada said, why not? You know, some story like that?
Could be. Then I went to New Zealand to see the deities and translation of the Buddha Swami. Deities are nice. I worship.
And Brisbane, Movilamba Farm.
Then we went to New Govardhan and the Byron Bay. Byron Bay is a city that's furthest to the east coast of Australia. Sun rises there first. So they have big Rath Yatra on New Year's Eve day from 9 p.m. till 12. And a few days before that, they have a festival on the beach. Usually they have a Rath Yatra on the beach, but this year we didn't do a Rath Yatra. There's Nahari Nam and a festival next to the beach. There a few hundred devotees at the Govardhan Byron Bay Festival. We stayed for 2 days. Highlight is the Rath Yatra. To do a Rath Yatra in the middle of New Year's Eve, it's a whole, you know, New Year's Eve is like that. But this is like an alternative village, alternative town. So they pass rules and orders and drink down the streets. It's illegal. in government this year. The government wrote to the devotees when they heard they were thinking about not going there and requested them to please do their Radha Yatra. Many years ago, there was a riot breaking shops and all those stuff during the New Year's Eve. So the year after that, we had a procession and it became very peaceful. Since then, that's part of the thing there. But they don't let McDonald's set up a shop there. It's all the old kind of rustic stuff. Some New Age 60s type people had set up this town already. Everybody there's a follower of some yoga or another. So it's a very interesting place. A lot of people come from outside to spread this east place. There was three Swamis there. Ramayana Swami chanted one time around with the Manikar to go around the town, things and all that. Jai, Gwani Tai, Radha Radha Moha. So I chanted for 1 hour and probably stood and asked. The next day we drove back and got back to 2-3 o'clock. Morning, got up early, flew this evening. Well, we inaugurated a new cultural center.
ISKCON Cultural Center?
ISKCON.
Wow.
ISKCON purchased 20-acre plot worth a couple $1 million, $2.5 million. But the idea was that it was a resort.
Wow.
With a capacity of 150 people. And they were making for alternative resort facilities, especially in Rwanda. So, in the middle of the song, he was there and others. We inaugurated that new facility. Because so many studies are made that the modern people, yoga, hatha yoga, and all this alternative lifestyle, meditation, everything, it's very huge market for that. So to provide that type of facility, which would then cultivate the people that are taking yoga classes or teaching yoga, such whether they also like to yoga also. We have this concept that they want to do that. And they purchased a place in our old Brandon Cash from Mayapur, he's heading it up.
The Brandon Cash? In his.
He was here many years ago. I was my second time.
Yeah, nice.
So, I flew with him. 9 in the morning, took rest till noon, went out there, woke up, spoke at this celebration till 2 was there for the trip was shot, caught the flight to Bangkok. Next day we did a Sunday program in the park in Bangkok. Then flew to Calcutta and gave the evening program in Calcutta. Calcutta program was Gita. That was. And then from there where we went, then we went to Mayapur 2 days. Then we came down to Orissa and got sick. But they had thousands of people, 20,000 people, 5,000, 10,000, it's huge people. December, this was Ramlal festival. Then they went to Calcutta and flew down to Coimbatore. 2 days Coimbatore Rath Yatra. And another universe. So many. There are a lot of people in the Rath Yatra procession. And there was then we went to Madurai. Our devotees, we went the night through to Sri Lanka, met with Nadumna Swami Mahakarta for the tsunami relief program. Our devotees have been distributing 10,000 plates a day at Tukumalai. So we discussed with him and decided that he would check it out at Ampang, something like that, in Batikulai, Eastern Coast. Chennai Rath Yatra, very nice also there. Thousands of people go a long way. Big hall filled up every night. Then from there we went to the youth festival in Pune.
Filled
up 4,000.
Food for life in Chennai.
And also the night of the 14th we went out for tsunami prasada relief. And about 1,000 plates were distributed. People were running when we got to the literally some people from a distance running. So I thought that was a good sign. Even if someone said, well, some of these people get some government food too, but somehow they're running, so I thought that was. We had a huge queue and the police helped us to get out. Mainly women and children, old ladies, it's few men. The youth festival. Tell us about the youth festival.
It was big. The first time they had this in India, National Youth Festival in India. About 4,000 to 5,000 youths came from all over India. So each ISKCON centers, they brought their own youth group. It's called ISKCON Youth Forum. And this big festival, they had this in big Maidan arena, and lot of swamis were there, Radhanath Maharaj, Loknath Maharaj. It's also part of the 108th celebration of Srila Prabhupada appearance day. And each ISKCON center, they set up their own stalls, nice exhibitions, like this. And the program was from the whole day, like from morning till late night, 10 o'clock.
Yeah, I was late 10 minutes and I missed my speaking slot. No, no mercy. They were very, you know.
No mercy.
Very timely. Very punctual. So it was like, good for the intellectual. And then from there we went, I went to Hyderabad. Hyderabad just started this year. Bhakti Viksha groups in their temple, and they found they had organized 20 groups, four sectors, and they said that they're getting the reports on the sadhana from the group members and things. So each sector takes charge of the Sunday feast. Four sectors, 4 weeks.
Wow.
And they find that it's really working good. They said it's revitalized the whole temple and they're ready to keep on expanding. Start up a 10 million tournament.
Bombay.
The Bombay for the meetings, continental meetings. Regional governing body committee. So you're meeting at the same time I was meeting. America.
It's for India.
For India, yeah. Then we went to the Middle East from Indra Rath Yatra and Mathura Desh. They have indoor Rath Yatra because you can't have it on the street, so there's one wall that they can get. They can go around the side. It's fun, it's all really great. 6,000 people to reach.
Well,
oh,
we could have started going to Georgia Dome.
Wow.
World Congress, I think.
Yeah, right. Yeah,
this is the size of a basketball.
6,000.
People come and go. For,
oh.
I think that's how many plates of prasad they used to. So 5,000. So actually, it was 6,000. Well, the right answer is interesting. They had initiations there, 55. All of them. All kinds of free all of them. And where did you go?
Delhi.
Did you go to Banket, the Hari Temple in Vrindavan?
Delhi for my permission to come to America, that was Tinch. See, then just as he gave me the permission to come, then he told me that there was some problem in my, on the internet, said there's a problem with my previous application. And maybe they will refuse me when I got to the border. That's why they were a little tense today. But somehow, by Krishna's mercy, I'm here. And they turn off the white radio. So then, Delhi, from Delhi, we went to open this temple. This a gentleman who has been an Abhat member. And he started off his life career repairing bicycles. So he was a know about bicycle spokes. So he got an idea of using the same technology of bicycle spokes. He made a better umbrella spoke. So he started making umbrellas. And then he started a factory making umbrella spokes. And he got a monopoly or major share of the umbrella spokes in India, at least in Eastern India. So with that, it's kind of a little niche. Don't think about it too much.
You know, a lot of them go.
Yeah, but there's a lot of them go.
Couple movies is fucking rest.
So he built a temple worth maybe 30 million rupees. But the story was told by Radha Krishna and Radha Nidhi, and this was quite amazing inspiration.
He didn't maybe go down Govardhan temple because it was raining down boats.
You went to, from there you went to Trivandrum. Cochin.
Cochin, we had a program. Also, this is a beautiful temple. Now, after you install the whole deities and the big festival, thousands of people, then he said, I'm going to give the whole thing to Iskam. But his life work was to build this temple.
Wow.
Now he's retired, his sons are now in the business, so he wants to just do a full-time puja ritual. Interesting. Let me give you a busy thing. I went to Cochin for an Amha program. And from there we went to the Middle East to Avatari Dish.
Cold name.
A lot of places in the Middle East. The programs are very intense. People were out. So that's how I'm going to keep you busy. Since November. Need some rest and then I'll be back at full speed tomorrow morning. For morning class and finale regular class tomorrow evening.
Yeah, that'd be nice. We'll be back at 7 o'clock or so.
7 o'clock.
Oh, it's not 6 o'clock?
Yes.
New York, 6?
Where was everyone tonight? Oh, for another 30 days?
Also, code 5.
I went to Moscow for 2 days, and there we had a. Now, because their temple is under development, the federal government, the new one, that started. So the congregation has no place to meet. So they had organized a big festival. Where I gave lectures. Other Swami led a kirtan. The darshan, some seminars, I think so. And from there, I went to Antwerp. Where the vice president of the temple is my disciple, and there's some of the boys, my disciples there. And, Antwerp is the diamond capital of the world, and most of the, many of the diamond merchants are Hindus or Indians. Mm-hmm. So, some of them want to build a temple for Iskam. So I met some of the diamond merchants. For Antwerp's sake. Nice people. And then nice people. Heavy computer. Glasses. And from Antwerp I came here. Here. Amsterdam. To the end. I didn't stop in Amsterdam. Just
Rotterdam.
Oh, on the way, we stopped in Rotterdam and gave an evening program in Rotterdam. It was packed with people. They had a little temple. 1 hour. one lady spent her life savings or some portion of it with a down payment to buy a new temple there, a little corner shop. The temple room was about as long as this temple room, but the width. The width is wide as from the pillar here. Maybe up to here. But it's not so wide, long and narrow. It was packed. So to the kirtan, everybody got up and they all started dancing and chanting. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Sankirtan Movement Key.
Jai!
Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.